trouble?
As you've been to us. Haul anchor and heave to, men! It's the wide and glorious main for us!
this light is full. Time to eat.
What? The blood in my mouth tastes like bile. Where's the brute that hit me, Nanny?
Nasty Pratt's out cold. Not dead, and more's the pity.
What did he want?
What they all want. Money he didn't earn. What were you thinking, butting into that mess? You could have been killed.
Nanny, my mind's in pieces. I still have terrible visions, and I need to know.
Out of the fire. Same as always. You need to move on, Alice. So do I. Well, at least she's not spewing that asylum nonsense. My past is dead, I killed them, I should have saved them, I should have died. Her mind was in shambles. Radcliffe thought familiar faces would bring her round. After a year, he lost interest in her inheritance, greedy sod. Still, always asking his bizarre questions. Heavy dose of madness, I'd say, but honesty is never the best policy in this life. When she wasn't comatose, she gaped, eyes like pinwheels, drooled, occasionally screeched. Never uttered a sensible sound. And like the child she was, she kept her secrets close.
Gone off some lurkers, common as cockroaches. And those poor tykes are food for perverts, like the blameless ants that wasps consume or spiders' feeble prey.
You visited my room at Rutledge. What were you...
Recall that? Radcliffe paid me. For a bit. A woman alone sometimes does what she doesn't particularly feel like doing. As you know.
Nurse Whitler said you'd fallen on hard times.
I'm no drunk like her. I'm hurting no one. Hooking's not a bad life.
Except for the pimps. She also said you might have my rabbit. Please, Nanny, talk about...
The damn fire never seems to help. Look, Alice, I can't give you what I don't have. Radcliffe wrote the inquest report. I'll take you to him. Besides, he's got your damn rabbit. You should remember that.
All right, but Mr. Radcliffe's useless.
Don't I know it?